Hello everyone, today I'm here to do one of my favorite tech videos that I do every single year, and that is the mid-year book freakout tag. So I've done this tag at least four or five times. I don't even remember. I'll link them all down below, as well as the questions and the original video. I love this tag because it's smack dab in the middle of the year, talks about what books you've read, what books you want to read, and just really rehashes the year so far. So without further ado, let's get into the questions because there's a lot of them and I have a lot of books to talk about. So the first question, obviously the biggest one, the best book you've read so far in 2020. For me, it's gonna be so hard. It's probably Crescent City by Sarah J. Maas. Also, there could be a strong contender for Reborn Yesterday by Tessa Bailey. I love both of these. These are both kind of adult paranormal. This one's definitely way heavy on the romance. This one's just straight up adult fantasy with a little bit of romance in it, but I loved both of these. So both of my favorites. We'll see how the end of the year fares out. Question number two is best sequel. So I haven't read any straight up sequels. Like, your girl's been really behind on like the fantasy YA game and just adult fantasy and sequel game. I've just been bad about it. The two sequels that I have read that are sequels technically, I guess, that are not really sequels, is Girl Gone Viral by Alicia Ryan. This is the second book in the Modern Love series, I believe she's calling it. As in, it's a sequel, but you could read it as a standalone. So technically it's a sequel. I loved it, would highly recommend it. Also, the same as with Happy Ever Playlist by Abby Hamezen. This is also the second book in a series. You can read both of these on their own if you want to, but technically they're sequels, so I'm counting them. Enjoyed them both a ton. Question number three is a new release you haven't read yet. Ooh, probably a lot. Here we go. Deck of Omens by Christine Lynn Herman. This one came out a few months ago. This is a sequel. I should have read this, and I could have really recommended a sequel if I loved it, but it's a YA fantasy that's a sequel to The Devouring Grey, which I read last year and really enjoyed. Question number four is most anticipated release for second half of the year, and I have a lot of them. First up, The Sky Beyond the Storm by Saba Tahir, the fourth and final book in the Ember and the Ashes series. I love it. That's one of my favorite YA fantasy series. I followed it from the beginning. I love that series, so I'm really excited to see how it's gonna wrap up. We've waited a few years for this book, and I feel like it's gonna break me to pieces, but I'm ready for it. Also, we have Midnight Sun by Stephanie Meyer, which is coming out in a couple months. I'm excited, but apprehensive. I don't know, we'll have to see. Well Played by Jen DeLuca, which is the sequel to Well Met, which is, again, a sequel slash companion novel that's like a Renaissance fair type of thing. I thought it was adorable, so I'm excited to read the sequel. And then I also have Vampires Never Get Old. This is an anthology that talks all about vampires. And if you guys haven't surmised by now, I'm really obsessed with vampires. Like, it's a problem. This has a whole bunch of authors in it. I can't wait to read it because vampires, I finally feel, are making a comeback this year, and I am here for it. Question number five is biggest disappointment of the year. I'm just gonna throw up this one. I was really, really excited for it. Also apprehensive, with good reason. Number six is biggest surprise. I have a lot of those. Number one probably would be You Deserve Each Other by Sarah Hoggle. I requested this on a whim and I read it on a whim and I loved it. It's about a couple that's engaged that like hates each other, and then they decide to kind of like, instead of breaking up, they decide to like kind of rehash their friendship and they fall in love again. I really liked it. It's kind of almost a toxic relationship. They learn how to get out of that toxic of it and try to love each other again. I liked it a ton, honestly. Another one that was very surprising to me is maybe these two thrillers. I wasn't expecting to love either of these, yet I gave both of them 5 stars. The Guest List by Lucy Foley, the ending, wow. And Home Before Dark by Riley Sager, my favorite Riley Sager book by far, obsessed with it. Was surprised I gave both of them 5 out of 5 because I rarely give out 5 out of 5 set of thrillers. Why? I don't know. Next up is your favorite new author. And this could mean a new author that has a debut book this year or a new to you author. And for me, that's going to be Elizabeth Acevedo. I've read 2 of her books this year and I really love them both. Plus, the covers are just insanely gorgeous. This one is written in all verse, which I found so interesting and so captivating. And this one was just amazing. I really love the way she writes and just love everything about her books. So she's definitely my favorite new author that I've discovered because she has a whole nother book that I need to read. I should probably read that really soon. The Poet X. Yes, I need to read that. I need to read that. We have Noah's fictional crush. And for the past couple years, I've left this blank because I'm like, I'm not really into that. But this year, your girl's got one. And who am I going to talk about? Another than Jonas from Reborn Yesterday. The vampire Jonas, who is just everything. Definitely my newest fictional crush. He can visit me anytime. Willing and ready. Our next question is newest favorite character. This one was hard, but honestly, I'm going to have to go with, forgive me, I'm stretching here. The March Sisters from Little Women. I finally read a classic this year. It was Little Women, and I really enjoyed it, and I definitely love the March Sisters. Like, goodness me, I adored them so much. So the whole family, really, are my newest favorite characters. Next up is a book that made you cry. And the only book that's made me cry this year, I would say, is Beech Read by Emily Henry, which is just really ironic because it's called Beech Read and looks like a light and fluffy read, and it kind of is, but it's got a lot of serious undertones in it, and I definitely teared up a lot during this. Next up is a book that made you happy. First up, Tweet Cube by Emma Lord. This is a YA contemporary that I read at the very beginning of this year, and I loved it so much. One of my favorite YA contemporaries I've ever read. It's adorable. Next up is How to Fail Flirting by Denise Williams. I read this on NetGalley, and I didn't realize it doesn't come out till December, so I really feel deceitful telling you this, but I loved it. It was adorable from start to finish, and I will be talking about this book a ton in December when it comes out. It's an adult romantic book that I love. This one is The Upside to Falling by Alex Light, I believe. It's a YA contemporary that I read randomly, and I thought it was adorable as well. I love those sugary sweet YA contemporaries any day. Next question is most beautiful book you bought this year. For me, I'm gonna have to say it's Clap When You Land by Elizabeth Acevedo. I mean, look at this cover. It is stunning, even on the hardback. Like, goodness me. It's freaking beautiful. I love it a ton. Another one, it's not really a beautiful cover, but it's definitely interesting, is My Best Friend's Exorcism by Grady Hendrix. It looks like an 80s VHS tape, and I'm here for it. And the last question is, what books need to read by the end of the year? Too many to name. A lot. And there you have it. That was the mid-year book freakout tag. I hope you guys enjoyed it and got some information about books I read and things like that. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.